Hi, hello there, and welcome back to the Architect's Workshop. I'm Lola of Tor, and in today's video, I'm going to be taking you through an introductory aspect of Milanotes and what it is. So, this particular series is created for interior designers or interior design enthusiasts, and how they can use Milanotes to organize their project, especially mood boards, specifically mood boards. So that's what I'm actually creating this series of videos for. So let's get right into it. So Milanotes is actually I was watching this YouTuber's videos. I really like her videos. What's her name? I like the way she says her name. Zaria Kuri. I don't know if I'm saying it right, but yes, her name is Zaria Kuri, right? So I was watching her videos, and I actually came across, like, she was actually advertising Milanotes to use in creating mood boards, organizing her interior design projects. So I was like, okay, I like how it looks. I like colors. Let me see how it looks like. So I actually went to her page. I actually Googled Milanotes, or did I use the link? I don't remember. I just checked it out, basically, and I saw that it was really fun. And it was really, really cool to use. Let me even bring up a picture of one of the first mood boards I made using this app.
A few moments later.
Yeah, so this is it. This is actually, like, I made this mood board for a living room that had a dining space in the same. It was a very small living room. So I exported it to my laptop. You can see that some of the reference ideas, I used the mood board template and I just played around with it a little bit. You see that some of them are still there because I was just starting out. This was the very first one and I was like, wow, I was blown away. But since then, I've used Milanotes and I found it to be a very helpful tool in sorting out your creative ideas. So why would I recommend Milanotes for interior designers? Basically, I found it to be very helpful because if you're a designer in any field, fashion design, interior, graphic, whatever type of product design, whatever type of designer you are, then it means that most likely you think visually. When I say visually, I mean you think in terms of pictures. You're thinking of, oh, a chair. Most visual thinkers will already be thinking, oh, is it a blue chair? Is it a white chair? They already imagine the color of the chair. Some people might think of it as white until you ascribe a color to that chair, or depending on the space they are sitting in, they might say, oh no, the chair has to be blue. They already ascribe a color to the chair because they are visual thinkers. So I found that Milanotes is actually really nice and really, really helpful when you're trying to organize these types of projects, because you're able to bring in pictures, inspiration pictures from different places. You're able to bring in you're able to sketch within it. You're able to put in your mood boards. I found it to be very useful for interior design because you can even use it to collaborate, share with your design teams, share with your clients. So for these and many more reasons, I actually really like Milanotes. And yeah, you can actually just sign up for free. You sign up for free and you can start using it for free, although there is a paid plan. So let's just sign up here. When you open, you just go to access it, you just go to milanotes.com, right? https, you can just type in milanotes.com in Google Chrome, right? When you do that, you just go to sign up for free, and then you just impute your details. So because me, I'm very, very lazy, I always sign up with Google. Yeah, just gonna use my Google account. And if you're like me, please feel free to do so. So review terms and conditions. I agree to terms, blah, 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 blah. Do not send me anything because I already have an account. And I'm just going to say continue, go back. So I'm going to pick, let's see, which one do I pick? Let's use the Architect's Workshop. So wait for it to load. The time it takes to load actually depends on how fast your internet connection is. I think mine is pretty decent, but well, it's not yet afternoon. We're in Nigeria. So yes, welcome to Milanotes. You are going to see this, and it's going to ask you, like, what are you? You can choose to pick other, or you can choose to skip this, but really it actually helps, because when you pick the specific industry you're in, they will keep showing you, like, more resources from that you can actually use, that they've developed, that you can actually use from that industry. So I picked interior designer, although as you can see, all these other people, developers, digital designers, entrepreneurs, writers, business managers, product managers, motion designers, all these types of people, they all use Milanotes. It's a really, really helpful tool, and I know that a lot of people have made tutorials on it. So I'm just going to pick interior designer, and I'm going to click continue. So when you come into Milanotes, actually there's like a mini tutorial, so it's actually pretty easy to do. Like, I'll see this one, it's like drag out a new board from here to get started. So I'm just going to click on it, hold down my left mouse key, and I'm going to drag it onto this board. So you see, let's give your new board a name. So I'm going to type on my keyboard, and I'm going to type my new mood board. There, I've named it, right? Now it says double click. So I just double clicked it, and you notice that this is the home page, and when I double click it, I've gotten into the mood board. So I'm just going to say okay. So now it's asking me, do I want an empty board, a project plan, a mood board, interior design brief, whatever, like even more templates I can look at. I can actually come here and just Google, I say Google, and just like search for interior design templates. So if I pick this one, it's going to bring up this type of template. If I click on it as yes, this is what I want. This is a sample mood board. So if I click on the design brief, interior design brief, you see that it brings up another template. And if I click on yet another interior design project plan, you see that it brings up yet another template. So they have these mini templates just to help get you started. I'm not a big fan of them, but I find them to be very useful if you're just coming in to Milanotes. This is how you actually sign up for Milanotes, and this is how you can get started for Milanotes. So let me just click this, use this template just to finish up the tutorial. So now you're ready to add some content to the board. So I'm going to say okay. It said try adding some notes and images. So I'm going to add notes over here. Yeah, anywhere, and expand as you type. Don't worry, we're still going to do like a step-by-step tutorial on how to bring in pictures, how to bring in images, and all of that. So as you can see, after I clicked on the mood board, all the images that were there before actually disappeared to give me the opportunity to bring in my own. So yes, this is Milanotes basically. I hope you really enjoyed this tutorial. I hope it's been helpful to you, and I hope to see you in the next episode where I show you how to actually download Milanotes to your desktop as a desktop app, and how to actually get the web clipper. So until next time, I'm Lola Oftol.